And it's the final game of the evening here at the Siegel Center in Richmond, Virginia, on the campus of Virginia Commonwealth University. This final semifinal will be between the Langley Saxum and the Floyd E. Kellam Knights. We are so happy that you guys decided to come along with us for this game tonight. Players are being introduced right now in this one. Tim Blank, your play-by-play man, alongside with me is Taylor Jensen. Taylor, we've seen a lot of great action here this afternoon and early evening, and it culminates with this showdown between a pair of really good volleyball teams.
Yeah, and I really don't think that we're going to be disappointed with this last match here. I mean, both teams come into this game with impressive records. I mean, the Kellam Knights are sitting at 30-2, and the Langley Saxons 25-5. And obviously, when you get to this stage of the postseason, you're here for a reason. This isn't by any stroke of luck that these two programs are here.
Well, you also have to take into account the fact that Langley actually lost the Northern Region Championship game lost the Northern Region Championship game to Stonebridge, who just lost in the previous semifinal to Atlee. I mean, Langley got here by defeating the Northwest Region champions, Patrick Henry Roanoke. So obviously they've got experience of being quote unquote giant killers, if you will.
Right, and so Langley comes into this game with an upset on their mind, and it doesn't matter who comes in here against Kellam, they're going to have upset on their mind because Kellam is the defending AAA state champs. So they're trying to repeat and defend their title and in a way show, hey, last year we were good, this year we're even better, and we're going to prove it by coming out here and winning two in a row, which is, I mean, to win one is tough. To win two is rare, and that's something they're trying to accomplish here, and they definitely have the tools to do it. They, for the most part, have a young team. I mean, you look at their roster, you see a significant amount of freshmen and sophomores, not a lot of seniors. About two or three, but they definitely have a loaded underclass on this team, so they'll be good for a while.
No question about that. I mean, if they stumble this year, I think that even though the seniors on the team won't like it, they certainly have a state championship under their belts. There probably won't be a shortage of players on this team that'll want to get another state championship under their belts. So we see the meeting of the coaches there at midcourt. We are just about ready to start things off. It has been a busy, busy day here at the Siegel Center. Absolutely a lot of action that just went on. Our first game of the day, Cosby won a four-set match against Great Ridge. Our second game, the Cox Falcons pushed their record to 31-0 with a straight set win over Cox. And, of course, just moments ago, finishing up an epic five-set match, the Atlee Raiders managed to squeak one out against the Stonebridge Bulldogs. So here we go for the final game of the evening, and we, I think, are in for a good one. So I think that we are going to not be disappointed at all with what we see here tonight. So here we go from the Siegel Center here in Richmond, Virginia. Kellam from Virginia Beach, Langley from McLean, Virginia. So you get the Northern Virginia against the Tidewater in this showdown.
Seems to be a trend in a lot of state championship appearances. Northern Virginia versus the beach area.
Always seems to have a very intense matchup. So we are just about ready to get things underway here. As we see, Kellam is going to have the opening serve, and serving for the Knights will be number four, Sydney Darden. There's the opening serve. We're underway. There's a couple of bumps right over there. Langley with a good return on that, and they take the first points of the game.
It looked like that was number 12 for the Saxons, Alex Andreev on the kill. The announcer just confirmed my hunch.
We're going to see what happens here the rest of the way. Here comes the serve. By Langley, and an ace right there. Beautiful job to put that where only she could get it. That, I believe, was Jessica Donaldson there on the serve. Here's the serve by Richardson again. She gets that one over. Little bump right there. Kellam going for the spike right there, but a good play to keep it alive for the Saxons. Saxons get it back over. The Knights trying to figure something out there. Manages to get it through there. Great play.
Good job for Kellam to get on the board. They communicate very well, as you can see by that possession there. They're in constant communication with each other, letting each other know where they are on the floor, what kind of set they want.
Here comes Kellam once again. There's the serve that time by Morgan Clark. Langley bumps it a couple of times. They keep it alive. They've got to chase this one. Kellam gets it over. Langley sets. There's the spike attempt. It falls. Kellam still keeping it alive. Langley also trying to keep it alive, but it's going to fall down, and we're tied at two.
And I got a feeling we are in for a treat of a game here tonight.
One can certainly hope there, Taylor. It's a good bump right there for Langley. They get it over. Kellam sets it up. They send it back over. They're going to rule it hits the line. 3-2 Kellam.
There was another bit of miscommunication there by the Saxons. Two players going for the ball. And you got to call it, say mine or something.
There's the set right there. Good spike right there. They're going to rule out of bounds. 4-2 Kellam. Kellam sets it up. Clark serves. And that one bumps off of the hands of the libero.
Well, that's going to be an ace there for Kellam. They're jumping out to an early lead.
This is not the kind of start that Langley wanted here. Here's the serve. They get that one back over this time. Spike attempt. This time they manage to get it onto the ground. And Langley cuts the lead. They come on up. Doing right there. It looks like that's Kelly Stancic there on the play. But the serve goes into the net. And it's 6-3 Kellam right now.
It's a costly service error. And we've seen plenty of errors tonight really contribute to teams losing sets.
See them setting that up. Langley with a good little bump right there. That one, got to give credit. Oh, man. Credit where it's due to Amanda Baloney. Credit where it's due to her. She was going after that one as best as she could. Just not enough on that.
Yeah, I mean, when you see a player giving their all, that's what happens. I mean, whether or not they come away with the point, she's hustling and trying to make a play for her team.
You always have to appreciate something like that. Kellam sets it up right there. Good bump. Langley keeps it alive. Little miscommunication, but they managed to get it back over. There's the bump at the serve. A beautiful one right there. That one's going to fall out of bounds. That's Chichi Osushuku right there who just absolutely just blasted that ball.
And Kellam really showing off a lot of their weapons right now on offense.
Rachel Wadsworth coming up here for the serve. She gets it up. Kind of feigned a jump serve, but she manages to get a little oomph on it. Good little bump that back way. Kellam sets it up. There's the spike, but it sails. And Langley is down two.
Langley hanging around with the defending champs.
Still early in the match so far, but... Here's the serve by Langley. And there's a good bump right there. Here's the setup. Kellam gets it over right into the one spot where no green jerseys are.
That's something Kellam does very well is picking their spots. And they are really good at dissecting other teams' defenses.
See them coming up right here. There's the serve by Kellam. The bump. He tried to feign it a little bit. Didn't get enough air to get it past number 11. Langley keeps it alive. There's the set. Good block there by the Knights. Langley keeps it alive. They get it back over to that side. And hold up right there. There's the boost. But they're going to rule a point over to Langley. Probably someone crossed the line over on the Langley side, on the Kellam side.
Well, that's a costly mistake by Kellam. They had a really good opportunity to get a kill. It was there.
Served by Langley. Not enough on that one. That was Caroline Mannon on that one. And as we see this, it's Paxton Crooks, one of the co-captains on the Knights, who sets it back up. Floats it over, but Kellam keeps it alive. And that time just dwindles its way over the net and finds a way to get in there. Ten to six here in the first game. There's a little bump. There's the set for Langley. Good spike and a terrific block on the front line by the Knights. That time, they got it going, but no, it's going back the other way, it looks like. And it falls in the middle. Communication, not one of the Saxons' strong suits to start the game.
They are just getting picked apart by Kellam.
11-6 right now between these two teams. There's the hit. There's the setup right there. Good play right there. Good save there by Rachel Frankenberger. That time they floated around, but Langley is set. They put it back down. And just not enough right there. And it's now 12-6 in favor of Kellam. You hear the Langley fans right behind us trying to get their team back into the game. There's that right there. Good play. Kellam keeps it alive, however. Good little spike right there. They're going to call that it's out of bounds, and it's a point to Kellam.
And these Langley fans are starting to get into it. We got a timeout.
Timeout Langley here on the floor. So it's a 7-point advantage for the Knights. Impressive job right now. So we're going to go ahead and step aside for a quick break here. We'll be back with more after this.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're going to come at you.
One shot at this.
And we're back. Kellam with the serve. You get the bump up there. A nice play right there. Kellam gets another point.
Rachel Solaski there on the block. She's the 5'10 middle blocker. She's a senior. One of the four seniors on this team.
As you see them coming up right here. Here's how it will go. There's the serve by Kellam. There's the bump. Langley with the set. There's the spike and a good block there by the Knights on the front line. And another one right there. Oh, man. It just rolled on the line right on the net right there, but it still fell out of bounds to Kellam.
I should have made a correction there. Four seniors on the floor, seven on the team.
It's very well then. There's the hit right there. And she sails the serve attempt. Langley gets the point.
Kellam really wants to steal momentum early. That's exactly what they've done. They've been able to really implement their game plan and impose their will on Langley throughout the game.
There's a serve this time by Jenna Dean. Good little bump right there, but it's going to be ruled a tip off the hands of Langley. Kellam absolutely running away with this first set, up 16-7.
Kellam is wasting no time. in this semifinal match. They want to hurry up and get this over with and advance.
There's the serve by Kellam. Langley keeps the ball alive with a nice bump. And there's a good point right there for the Saxons. Saxons trying to keep this one going. You see the serve getting ready by Jessica Donaldson. She gets this one up and over. Good bump there by Kellam. Knights get a good bounce right there. Langley tries to keep it alive, but nothing doing. A little too much backspin on that ball.
The Saxons are reeling in the first set, trying to figure out how they can start putting some points on the board and get some stops. They're really having trouble returning these kills from Kellam.
There's the serve. There's the bump and the spike right there, but it lands out of bounds. But the Langley fans are calling. Langley fans demanding a touch on this one. We're still waiting for the official word right here. We're still waiting for some kind of an official word. And they put the point to Kellam, but now it's... Give the point to Kellam on that one, but they managed to sail that one. So it's now 18-9 in favor. 18-9 in favor of Kellam right now as Hoi Nam Bui sets up the serve for Langley. Good serve, but she sails that one. And it's out. And it's now 19-9. Kellam setting up right here. There's the serve. There's the bump. There's the set for Langley. They try to get the spike, but they get the tip on that one. No debates there, and it's now 19-10.
Langley showing a little fight here.
As we see Langley preparing to do the serve once again. Alex Andrzejew set the serve it for the Saxons. She gets that one off. Good bump there by Kellam. They're bumping it left and right here. They keep it in, but it goes outside the pole. And it's now 20-10.
And that was number 11, Paxton Brooks. Just kind of hitting it right over the net both times. Really composed, like she knew she was going to win that exchange.
Here they come right here with the serve. Kellam trying to do something good here. That's Rachel Wadsworth setting up. He hit the Langley faithful trying to get their team going. We're still waiting on this. Guess the side judge is having a bit of a discussion with the scorers. And we are set to go. And we now finally have everything set. Here it comes. Here's the serve by Wadsworth. Langley's got to bump this one to keep it alive. They get it over and still in play. Kellam sets it up. Good spike right there by number 3 on Kellam. Impressive.
They are already just running away with this first set, up 11. Their hitters are just really what the main headline of this game is so far.
There's the bump right there. There's the set by Bui. And try to get a spike that time, and they manage to scoot it over, but it lands out of bounds. Langley gets the point on that one. To 11 the score here in the first game.
Nice break there for the Saxons.
We see Catherine Beck coming up here to serve. There's the bump. There's the set. Oh, man, going back and forth. Langley gets the point on that one. I'm not sure where I missed something there, unfortunately. But it's 22-11. Serve by the Knights. Good bump there by Bowie. There's the set. Nice little spike right there. Trying to set it up, but now they're going to go. They're going to rule that a double on Kellam, so Langley gets the point. They set things up right here. Caroline Mannon set to serve. There's the bump. And it hits the bar right there. Rules out. Langley gets the point.
Langley on a little bit of a run here. A 3-0 run for the Saxons.
Anything that they want to do to try to build some momentum going forward in this event. Good serve by Langley. There's the bump. There's the set. They get it over, but a good dig right there to keep it alive. And unfortunately, that last hit goes out of bounds, and so it's 23 for Kellam.
And Kellam is really going to try and put it away here. 2 points till the end of this set. And Langley's going to call a timeout.
Langley's going to call their second timeout here of this game. It's pretty apparent right now why the... pretty apparent right now why the Knights are the defending state champions. Wouldn't you say so, Tyler? Taylor?
Well, I would completely agree. And you know what? Like we said earlier, they're just going to reload next year. They're not going to have a rebuilding year when you've got that many underclassmen just itching to take over the reins of the team. So they'll be all right. And they've got some great coaching over there, too. You can always tell that when a team is going back-to-back state final appearances, I mean, that really says a lot about the coaching staff to be able to get their team to that level year in and year out.
Well, they come back up here to the floor here. Langley down 10. There's the serve by Kellam. Langley going for the return. There's the set and the spike right there, but a good bump by Bowie keeps it alive. Good play right there, but Kellam keeps it alive. And a nice spike right there, Langley keeping it alive. And they're going to give a point to... They're going to give the point to Kellam there on that one. So it's now game point. There they bumping it around. Trying to get it over there. Bowie keeps it alive for Langley. Good bump right there. Another good one. And a nice little soft kill right there gives the first game to the Kellam Knights.
And that was an impressive out-of-the-gate performance from the Knights.
No question about that. Kellam showing why they are regarded as one of the top teams in the state. So it's just an impressive debut there for the Knights in this one. They are well on their way. Langley's got to find some answers, and they got to find it fast if they are going to stay in this ball game. So we're going to go ahead now, take ourselves a bit of a break. We'll be back with the start of game number two here on the VHSL Network here between Langley and Saxon. Langley and Kellam, I should say.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot.
We
get a player up here.
Oh, that's good stuff.
All right, perfect. Prepare a Wiley Ballard graphic.
Do you want me to start the stream?
Start the stream.
Camera three.
Beautiful.
Oh, we're coming in on one.
For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program, go to playonsports.com/SBP.
And we're back here on the VHSL Network for this girls' volleyball semifinal between the Kellam Knights and the Langley Saxons. The Knights absolutely dominating the first game, 25-13. You kind of have to wonder, in a situation like this, what would Susan Shiflett say to her girls to try to get them motivated here in the second game, Tyler?
Well, I would imagine that she would tell them to just regain their composure. They definitely seemed rattled out of the gate that, you know, they're going up against the mighty Kellam Knights. But in all reality, I mean, they put on their uniform one shoe at a time, just like every other team. So, you know, she's definitely trying to motivate her team right now and just get them to pick up their performance and not play almost intimidated by those black uniforms on the other side of the net.
I think something that does need to happen with Langley is that they got to communicate a lot better. I think that the communication was a real weakness for them in that first game. So we see them coming up here to the court. They're getting set here for game number two. They've swapped sides, and they're getting ready to go once again. See them setting up right now. Setting up to serve is number 9, Jenna Dean, one of the co-captains for the Saxons. See them coming up right here. Dean setting up. There's the hit. There's the bump. Kellam trying to set things up. Nice soft touch right there, and Kellam takes the early point.
And Kellam really wants to go pedal to the metal in this second set. They want to put this game away quickly. They want to be able to save their legs and everything for the state final. But Langley has got other plans.
There's the bump right there. Coming over right here. Goes out of bounds this way. Langley now down 2-0.
Getting up close and personal with some of these players. It's about the second or third time that's come over this direction today.
Thankfully, nowhere near close to the computer. I think that we can at least thank ourselves for that. There's a nice little bump, and it hits the pole. Ruled out, and it's now 3-0 Kellam. And they coming up here to the line. There's the hit. There's the bump. There's the set. Langley trying to get a spike right there. They're going to rule that one a touch off of Langley, and they get on the board.
Let's see if Langley can build on that.
Jessica Donaldson setting up for the serve. Gets that one across. Good little bump. Nice block there by Langley to set it back up over here. Oh, and we have to wonder. They're going to call that number 3 reached over. So that's a 3-2 game right now. Oshikuchu gets called for the violation on that one to bring Langley to within one. Nice little bump right there, but a good save. Nice blast right there for Langley, and they have tied this game up. Jenna Dean, way to go.
Looks like Langley had a little bit of Red Bull. They're awake. Trying to get Kellam playing on their heels.
Probably more awake than we are at this point.
Game number 4, I believe.
Game number 4 for today. Here comes Donaldson again with the serve. There's the bump and the set. Good spike right there. Langley bumps it high to keep it alive. Good set right there and a nice spike. Keeps it alive. Nice little floater right there by Kellam right there for the defense. And a great play right there. Lexi Donaldson to get the point on the board. Langley takes the lead.
Langley is slowly starting to steal some of this momentum. Slowly but surely.
They're going to set things up right here. There's the hit. There's a little bump right there. Good hit right there. Good block. But it's going to fall down right there. Kellum's going to tie this one up.
Kellam wanting to tell Langley to pop the brakes.
You can tell them all they want. I don't think that they're going to listen.
Oh, I agree completely.
Here comes Rachel Wadsworth with the serve. Bowie trying to get something done right there. And what a kill right there. Holy smokes.
We got a rocket.
Sydney Darden puts that one, just zips it right past anyone wearing a green uniform.
Sydney Darden is one of the other seniors on this team, outside hitter, and she's showing why she plays that position.
There's the serve for Kellam. And a nice play right there for Langley. Alex Andrzejew ties the game up. High five right here. Langley trying to do anything they can to get back in this one. Bowie with the serve. She gets it across. Bowie, another good bump to keep it alive. And she gets a good little strike right there. Langley takes the lead.
See, one thing I'm noticing is Langley is coming out playing with some fire in their belly this set, and Kellam's almost just comfortable. They're not really having that attack aggressive mindset right now.
There's the serve by Bowie. Kellam gets it back over. Here comes Langley. There's the set. Nice little spike. It bumps off. Kellam somehow gets it back over. Good little shot right there. They're going to rule that it was out of bounds. Kellam ties it back up. Come back up here waiting for something. There's the bump. There's the serve. Good little slap right there on the strike attempt. That time it didn't work nearly as well.
So now Kellam jumps back out in the lead. And they'd like to keep it that way, but Langley just keeps battling back. You got to give credit to them. They're bouncing back from that poor showing in the first set.
Certainly are. There's a nice little bump right there. There's the set. Man! Holy smokes. Sydney Darden. I mean, with the leg taped up and everything. There's the serve by Kellam. Good little bump by Bowie. They get it back over to the side for Kellam. And nice little play right there. They're going to rule that a double. So it's now 9-6 in favor of the Knights. As we see coming up here for Kellam, Morgan Clark set to serve. So the bump, there's the set. Here comes the spike attempt and a great block at the front line by the Knights. It's now 10-6. There's the spike right there. There's the bump, the set. Langley tries to spike once again. Now Kellam trying to set it up, and they're going to rule out of bounds. No, they're going to rule inbounds. Point to Kellam. Eleven to six here in the second game. Kellam ahead of Langley. Served by Clark. There's the bump by Bowie. That one bounces off the top of the net. And it's just not looking good here for the Saxons.
Kellam on a little run, and Langley's going to call their timeout.
Certainly not what they wanted to do here in this one. We're going to go ahead and step aside for a quick break. We're back with more on the VHSL Network.
We can get a player up here.
Oh, that's good stuff.
A Wiley Ballard graphic.
Do you want me to start the stream?
Start the stream. Camera three. Beautiful. Oh, we're coming in on one.
For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program, go to playonsports.com/SBP.
Welcome back to the 2012 VHSL Girls Volleyball Semifinal here between the Kellam Knights and the Langley Saxons. Kellam up 12-6 here in the second game. Kellam dominated the first set en route, and now they have the advantage at the moment. There's the bump by Bowie. There's the set. Good block there by the Knights, but they're going to rule that they reached over on that one, so it's now going to be 12-7. Here they come, coming up right here. 12-7 is our score. We set it up. There's the bump. There's the boom. A nice little bump right there. Here it comes over this way. Langley cannot get to it. They're going to rule that a point for the Knights.
And I got to give credit to Kellam setter, Paxton Crooks. She's the senior on the team, and she is doing a phenomenal job of setting her teammates up to be able to make effective kills.
And there's the bump right there. Langley trying their best to get back into this. They sail that, though, so it's now 14-7. Kellam ahead of Langley. There's the bump for Langley. There's the set. Langley tries to get something on the spike, but nothing doing. Kellam is right there to put it away. Bowie gets it going the right way. Kellam gets it going back. Langley now trying to figure something out. There's the spike, but she sails it.
Just got to get on top of the ball a little bit better. The right idea, those corners are there. Just got to get on top of it.
Always a calculated risk when you go for the corners. So you see a number 11 setting up here for Kellam. And a good bump back right there. Forces that one over. It's another bump and a boom. Good little play right there, and it's going to rule the touch on Langley. Point goes to the Knights. Here they come up to the line right here. There's the set. They get the ball over. Good spike right there, but not enough. Bowie gets a good dig right there to keep it away. Keep it in play, I should say. Oh, and a collision right there between two players. A bit of miscommunication. Tries to get the floater there. They got to get it over this time. They managed to do so. Good block on the part of the Saxons. And that time, just enough right there.
Rachel Frankenberger on the kill.
Sydney Darden also with a little bit of credit right there. Now 17-7. Kellam over Langley here in this second semifinal of the girls' volleyball championship. There's this play right over there. They're going to rule that one off of Kellam, so it's going to be 17-8 now. Catherine Bake is going back into the game for Langley. There's the serve. Good bump right there. There's the set. And a good block on the part of Kellam gives them the points right there. Make it 18-8. Ooh.
Now Saxons have a lot of work to do in this set.
A lot of work to do and not a whole lot of time. Kellam just pulling away from them. And a nice block at the front of the line. The Knights just imposing their will at the moment. And now it's going to be a second timeout for the Saxons. Going to go ahead and take ourselves another break here on the VHSL Network. We'll be back with more after this.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're going to come at you.
One shot at this.
We hear the couple of Langley cheerleaders trying to get their fans motivated in this. Langley just being handled easily by the Kellam Knights, the defending state champions. There's the serve by Dryden. And there's the set. Good spike right there, but it goes into the net. And that's a point for Kellam.
Kellam just on an unbelievable run right now. They're on a 14-2 run.
They are capable of that, but the next serve goes right into the net, so it's now 20-9 here in the second game. We also see coming up right here, Caroline Mannon about to serve for the Saxons. She gets that one over, almost gets an ace. Good little bump over there. Nice one right there, but a good dig to save the point for the Knights. Good block on the part of the Saxons. Floats it back over, trying to get something going. And then the spike goes into the net. Langley gets the 10.
Just a little bit of an error there, so Langley's going to capitalize on it, get the point, and the ball to serve.
Mannon trying to do something here. Floats it up. Gets bumped, and a good little bump right there. Comes back the other way. Good play right there, and Kellam gets the point. Good serve right there for Kellam. Good play right over there. There's the bump and the spike right there, but a good dig right there to save it. Good bump right there and a nice kill to make it 22-10. Kellam 3 points away from setting themselves up with a 2-0 series lead. Good bump on that right there. Here's the set. Good spike. Oh, and what a save there by the Kellam Knights. A little bump over top. Kellam trying to keep it up. There's the spot, and it goes in, 23. Give a really shout out there to Riley King, who got the block that really kind of set everything up right there.
And Kellam just almost a pater. Now just two more points.
There's the serve. She sails the serve, so Langley's going to get the point and the ball back to serve.
Boy, Langley still believing, though. They are still pepped up.
They're not giving this one up, even though they have been outmatched by the Knights. They are certainly no shortage of believers on that team. There's the spot right there. Good dig to save it from an ace. Kellam. There's the hop and the bump, and that one goes off. That one's going to land out. It's going to be ruled a touch by... Hold on a moment. We're going to wait for the...
So Kellam's going to get the point.
Kellam is going to get the point, so it's going up to game point here. Here's the pitch. And that one bounces off of the net, and Kellam wins the second game, 25-11. Langley fans not giving up on their girls, but they got a long, but they got a very, very high hill to climb here, and not a lot of time to do it. Kellam Knights utterly dominating the game so far. So we're going to go ahead, step aside here with the break here going into the third and possibly deciding game of this semifinal with the Kellam Knights leading two games. Two games to none.
One match away from immortality.
This is a total team effort.
We're gonna come at you.
One shot.
Start the stream.
Camera three.
Beautiful.
Oh, we're coming in on one.
For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program, go to playonsports.com/SBP.
And we're back here at the Siegel Center here in Richmond, Virginia, where the Kellam Knights have taken a dominant 2-0 lead over the Langley Saxon in the second VHSL girls volleyball semifinal. Kellam now just 25 points separating them with a date with Atlee on Saturday night.
And this game is either going to be a case of either domination by the Kellam Knights or a miracle of a night for the Langley Saxons.
Miracle is just about, I think, as much as I hate to say it, it's going to be as much of what Langley is going to need to, I think, even win the next set, much less the entire match. You just look over at Kellam. They just have athletes for days over on that side. Not to disparage any of the accomplishments that the Saxons have done this season, but I just look at Kellam, and that is just probably one of the best teams I've seen. This is probably the best team I've seen today other than Cox. And here we go right here, start of the third set. Kellam, good spike right there. Langley keeps it alive. There's the bump right there. Good spike right there, but Langley still finding ways to keep it alive.
Langley really doing a good job defensively here.
Good spike right there, and Langley still keeps it alive. Langley still keeping it alive. They're not going away. And they're going to get ruled with a palm ball on that one, so Kellam to the Saxons.
Kellam just couldn't find an opening there. I mean, Langley hung tough, but that's what you want to see if you're the Saxons coach, and their fans even, is hanging tough defensively, because that's something they've struggled with here throughout the night.
They are certainly going to be hanging tough. There's going to be no quit on this team at all. Kellam setting it up. Floats that one over. Good little hit right there. Gets through the Kellam defenses. Langley has a 2-0 lead here in the third game. In the third game. Sails that one, but they're going to rule it tipped off of Langley, so it's going to be 2-1. Point goes to Kellam. There's the hit over on that side. There's the bump, the set. Try to float that one over. Kellam with a nice play right there to get it back to their key killer. And boy, does she take a moment and
that was a little bit of quick trickery there. They acted like they were about to just knock it over the net, and she sends it right back to their middle hitter.
Kellam with a serve. Langley hits it right back. And a good play right there, but Langley keeps it alive. She still keeps it alive right there. Langley tried for something, lands in bounds, and Langley takes the lead.
That was a great job there by Langley to find the weak spot on the floor. Kellam making a couple substitutions, going to try and right the ship. They are down early in the third set.
Langley gets it back. Good play right there. They're going to rule against the Knights. Point to Langley. So the Saxons, despite being dominated in the first two sets, showing life here with their season on the line. A good serve there by Bowie. And the return gets airmailed, and it's now 5-2.
A little bit of frustration this set here from Kellam.
Another quick substitution there by the Knights. Set it up right here. There's the bump. Kellam keeps it going. Langley with the setup. Good spike right there, and it hits the ground. 6-2, Langley. There's the setup right there. There's the bump. There's the set, and the spike. Terrific play.
Boy, Kellam says, we've had enough. Because that was a monster kill right there. From the middle blocker. That was number three. Chichi, also Chukwu.
Tough name to say, I'm sure, but you know, she is definitely showing herself why she is one of the stars of that Knights team. Good spike there by Langley, but she airmails it. Falls out of bounds. Kellam gets the point. There's the point right there. There's the set. And somehow, now they're going to rule that it landed in bounds. Langley's going to get the point.
Langley showing signs of life. And they've got Kellam dazed right now.
There's the bump right there. There's the set. Good play right there, but it goes right into the net right there, so point goes to Kellam. It's 7-4 here in favor of Langley here in the third game. Here's a serve by Kellam. A couple of good bumps, and a nice little touchdown there. What's Kellam to within two? There's the serve right there. Langley with the bump. Gets it over. Kellam gets it back over. But it hits the pole right there, so it's going to be 7-6.
And again, a little bit of deception there from Kellam from Paxton Crooks. Acts like she's about to set the ball, and then she just spikes it over real quick. But good job by the Saxons to really be on top of it. They're playing very well this set.
Indeed they are. Nice play right there. They try to keep it up. Ball still in play. They're going to rule that a double on Kellam. Double hit on Langley, I should say, so it's a point to Kellam. There's the serve right there. That one goes way out of range, but they managed to get it back over. And a great kill right there. It's going to land out of bounds, however. Langley gets the point.
Kellam is really struggling to get in any kind of rhythm this set. Not really being able to accomplish what they were wanting to do earlier. Langley is really showing signs of life here. It would be great to see them come away with one.
And, oh, a terrific block on the front line for the Saxons. Knights get it back over. Saxons get ready to set it back, send it back. But they airmail that one. Now it's tied at 8. Set this one up. Here's the serve. There's the bump, the set. Good spike, but a good block at the front line. That time that worked, and Langley gets the point. And the Saxons trying to do anything they can to get back into this. Jenna Dean with the serve. Nice little touch over the top there by number 4 of Kellam to even things up at 9.
Kellam wanting to get on a little bit of a run here.
Nice little bump right there. Good smack right there. And a good play right there, and it lands out of bounds. Point to Kellam, and Kellam takes the lead 10-9.
And this is about the point where Kellam has really taken over in the last two sets. Is the closer it gets to the 10-point mark when they start to really catch fire.
Saxon's trying to prevent something like that from happening. Good play to keep that going there by the Knights. Good little touch right there. But a nice kill right there, but Langley still keeps it alive. Here comes another bump. Good block right there. But Bowie hits it. She probably should have let that one go out of bounds.
Now Kellam is up by 2.
Could this be the beginning of the finale? There's the hit. There's the bump. There's the set. Good spike there by Langley.
And that was number 15, Maureen Marsh, and she gets a lot of power behind her kills, and they are very tough to return.
They set things up here. 11-10 is the score. Good serve there. There's the bump. There's the set. Knights try to get a little finesse right there. That time it went off, but it managed to land in bounds. Kellam now with a 12-10 lead. Here come the Knights once again. There's the serve, and that's an ace.
Kellam really starting to try to pour it on here. Got the 3-point lead, and again, this is the point of the game where they really start to get into a rhythm. Langley has got to get a stop here.
There's the spot right there. Good little bump right there to keep it over. Completely caught Kellam off guard, but Kellam finds a way to respond to that. and return it.
Very fortunate dig there for Kellam, because once it bounced off their player's hand, it actually ended up being a perfect set for a kill.
There's the bump right there. Goes right into the net. Langley down three here in the third set. Kellam trying to figure something out here. There's the serve. There's the set. And now that one is going to go out of bounds, and it's now 14-12.
A great effort there to try and at least make a play out of it. They don't just look at it and assume, oh, well, it's going out of bounds, and just give up. They keep trying to make something out of nothing.
Here's the serve by Langley. Gets across. Good dig there by Kellam. They try to float this one over, but not enough on that one. Langley now down one in the game.
And you can see the reaction on Rachel Slasky's face. She knew she had it, but she just kind of lost it on the way up.
And it's going to be a timeout here for Kellam, trying to regroup and try to figure out what is going on out there. But looking at the coaches right now, they don't look that worried at the moment. Here they come back to the line. Kellam wanting to put this one away and get it and earn themselves a date with Atlee in the state championship game set for Saturday night, 7 p.m. And you can watch that right here on the VHSL network. And as a matter of fact, we have six semifinal games scheduled for Friday in all the divisions. There's the bump. Good little bump right there. There's the set. Look out over this way. Langley can't control that one.
I think that just defined the term velocity right there.
I think so. We should be glad it wasn't coming at one of our mugs.
I can't afford to break my nose again, so I'll keep my fingers crossed.
There's the bump right there. There's the hit. And a good spike right there. But they're going to rule it out of bounds and going to give the point to Kellam. So it's going to be 16-13.
Got to give credit to the Saxons. I mean, they are really playing tough.
I mean, I think that the score itself is really not indicative of just how hard these girls have played tonight. Good play right there. That's 14-14, and it's making it 16-14.
You got to wonder what kind of game this would be if this version of the Saxons would have been in the first and second set.
There's a serve by Langley. Good little dig right there for Kellam. Kellam with the serve right there. That one's going to score it away, and that one's going to go down. It's going to be 17-14. You see them coming up right here. There's a serve by Kellam. Bump by Langley. They get it up. Tries to get the bump. They're going to rule a double, a four hit right there, and Kellum's going to get the point. There's seven. They sense at the end is in sight. 7 points away from a date with Atlee. There's the serve. Almost an ace, but they managed to dig it out. Nice little floater right there. Here's the bump over to this side. That one falls to the ground. Kellam, 19 points. And Langley is taking their first time out of this game. With that, we're going to go ahead and step aside for a quick break here on the VHSL Network.
We can get a player up here.
Oh, that's good stuff.
Prepare a Wiley Ballard graphic.
Do you want me to start the stream?
Start the stream.
Camera three.
Beautiful.
Oh, we're coming in on one.
For more information on how your school can join the Play On School broadcast program, go to playonsports.com/SBP.
And we're back here on the VHSL Network. 19-14, Kellam over Langley here in the third game. Kellam looking for their for a return trip to the state finals. And a good play right there puts it right over. And they have broken the 20-point mark.
And those plays right there that happen at the net are just a battle of pure strength and who's going to win out on that. And right there we saw the Knights came away with the point.
There's the serve right there. There's the bump. And a good little bump right there. They're going to rule. They're going to rule for the Knights.
So Kellam only 4 points away from putting away the Saxons and moving on to face Atlee.
I have to give the Saxons credit. They have not given up, even though it looks as though they have been completely outmatched. They have played their hearts out here tonight. There's the bump right there. Four hits for the Saxons. So Kellam now 3 points away.
The Saxons are going to play hard until they can't play anymore. That's just a fact.
I don't think there's any questions there. You see them setting up here for the serve. Bowie with the bump. There's the set. Decent spike right there. It's going to go out of bounds. Langley gets a point right there to make it 22-15. There's a serve, and they get an ace on that one.
Like I said, Langley's not going to quit until that final whistle blows. That's an impressive ace right there.
No question about that. They need a few more of those here. Not to be on that one. Good play on that. And way
wow.
to get that one over the net. But an impressive kill right there by Chi-Chi. Kellam now 2 points away from returning to the state finals. Waiting for the ball here. And they get the ball right there. Rachel Woodsworth setting up for the serve. Gets that one across. Langley bumps it. There's the set. Tries to float that one over. Good play right there.
No, but it's out of bounds.
So they're going to rule it out and point to Langley. So Langley's sticking around. Now down 6, 23-17. They got to make something happen here in the next couple of moments. There's the serve by Langley. There's the bump. Nice play right there. Good play right there. Coming over this direction. And a good play right there. Point to the Saxons. So 23-18, Langley finding ways to stay in it. There's the serve right there for Langley. Kellam trying to go for something, but the Saxons keep it alive. But that one dies on their attempt right there. So now point to Kellam, and it is match point.
This next point for Kellam will send them to a date Saturday night with Atlee.
And Langley is going to take their final timeout here to try to see if they got any kind of magic tricks in that black hat of theirs to see if they can extend the season any longer than they can. As I've said, I don't think that the score is at all indicative of how hard these ladies have played tonight. Kellam is just, I think, that good. And I think that Atlee is in for a big challenge. Is in for a big challenge on Saturday night.
Well, here's an interesting fact. Kellam and Atlee actually met in the regular season, and guess who won?
Atlee. Wow,
so it'll make for an interesting night on Saturday.
Saturday night, we will be here broadcasting live from the Siegel Center. Langley setting it up. There's the kill right there. And Langley keeps their season going. Langley trying their best to keep this going. Got to give credit where all there is due. There's the serve by Langley and the bump. The set and a good block right there, but it goes out of bounds. Point to Kellam, and the Kellam Knights are going to the state championship game. So congratulations to the Kellam Knights, and bravo to the Langley Saxons. The Saxons really finding that it was a hard game, and give them credit where it was due. They battled throughout that entire game. If you look at that team over there, I don't see one sad face over on that side. I think that everyone is quite happy with the fact that they've got that far, and they know that they gave it their all. They just ran into a buzzsaw tonight. So that is going to do it for us here on the VHSL Network. There's your final score right there. Three wins on the part of the Kellam Knights with a straight set. On the part of the Kellam Knights. So that is going to do it. It's been a long day for us here at the Siegel Center. Tomorrow's only going to be even longer with six semifinal matchups here on the VHSL Network. You just hear how much love these fans have for their team. So that is going to do it from us here at the Siegel Center for this afternoon. Thank you once again for joining us. This has been the VHSL Network with the Virginia State Championships. Have a great night. We will see you tomorrow.